Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. If someone asks me, who are you? I'm probably going to say, I'm Afnan. No. I'm not asking you your name. If I wanted to know your name, I would have asked, what is your name? I'm asking you, who are you? Silence. No answer. कुछ लोगों से जब ये सवाल होता है कि आप कौन हैं, तो जवाब आता है, भाई मैं अहमद हूँ और मैं यहाँ से आया हूँ. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, मैं शायद बीकन हाउस से आया हूँ, या मैं लाइसियम से आया हूँ, या मैं KGS या फलां फलां से आया हूँ. कुछ लोगों से पूछेंगे, यार मैं दानियाल हूँ और मैं इस्लामाबाद से आया हूँ. इफ यू आस्क समवन हूज कम फ्रॉम अब्रॉड, ओके आई एम जॉन, आई एम फ्रॉम अमेरिका. व्हाई आर देयर डिफरेंसेस? सम रिलेटिंग टू अ कॉलेज, यूनिवर्सिटी, स्कूल, सम रिलेटिंग टू अ प्लेस फ्रॉम वेयर दे आर, एंड सम वुड से, ओके आई एम फ्रॉम दिस कंपनी. व्हाई सच डिफरेंसेस? व्हाई? Basically, or if you ask me, I would probably say that I'm Afnan and I'm from Nust. But that also depends on the person who's asking me. For example, if any one of you is asking me, then I would probably say that, yes, I'm from Nust. But if I were to be in a seminar where there are people from all over the world, corporates and stuff, I would probably say that I'm from GSK. Now, again, differences. Why? The thing is, I or anyone else, when answering this question, want to establish an impression upon the person who's asking this question. We want to make sure that person realizes who he is talking. I'm not just nobody. I'm not just anybody. You need to know who I am, because I am somebody. Okay, you are somebody. But are you really somebody? लोगों के सामने तो मतलब आता है कि यार इंप्रेशन जमाना है, रोब जमाना है, ताकि उसको ये ना लगे कि यार मैं उससे कमतर हूँ. उसके लेवल पे या उसके ऊपर से ही आना है, नीचे से नहीं आना. बट व्हेन यू गो बैक, व्हेन यू आर अलोन, और व्हेन यू आर ड्राइविंग बैक होम, एंड व्हेन यू आर विद योर माइंड, यू आर विद द वॉइसेस इन योर हेड, डू यू रियली थिंक यू आर समबडी? डू यू रियली थिंक अबाउट योरसेल्फ? डू यू रियली थिंक वेयर यू गोइंग? एंड यू रियलाइज दैट देयर आर टू फेसेस ऑफ यू. देयर इज अ फेस दैट इज इन फ्रंट ऑफ द पीपल, एंड देन देयर इज अ फेस व्हिच इज देयर व्हेन देयर इज नो वन एल्स. इजंट दिस हिपोक्रेसी? मे बी इट इज, बट इट इज ऑल्सो अ पार्ट एडमिटिंग that you are lost, my friend. You are lost. You may feel that you are not. You may not want to admit it, that you are lost. But believe me, when you have these thoughts, these voices in your head that are telling you one thing and you're portraying something else in front of others, you are lost. And be true to yourself. When you're alone, be true to yourself. Admit that you are lost. Because unless and until you admit that you're lost, you're never going to be found. You have to admit that you are lost so that you can embark upon that journey of finding yourself. That is the longest journey, the hardest journey of finding yourself. Because once you find yourself, then you're going to be able to move mountains. Trust me on this. Unless and until you know where you're going, you know what you're doing, and you know why you are doing what you're doing, you cannot move mountains, my friend. People have gone from slums, from here to up here, just by believing in themselves. They found themselves, they believed in themselves, they understood themselves, and they had a vision. Don't be afraid to fall apart. Because unless and until you realize that you are falling apart, you cannot rebuild yourself. Why would I want to rebuild myself? Point. Sometimes we feel we are at some place, but circumstances have led us to be at that place. And we feel, if so and so wouldn't have happened, I wouldn't have been here, I would have been somewhere else. Okay, period. Take a break, fresh start, it's your life. Do it the way you want. Fall apart, rebuild, and rebuild on the principles that you want in your life, no one else. On the values that you have for your life, no one else. On the interests which define you, not anybody else. Mark Twain, famous author, he says, I can teach anybody how to get what they want. Problem is, I don't have many people who can tell me what they want. People don't know what they want out of this life. They're living day in, day out, spending hours working or doing nonsense or rubbish, spending days, spending nights, not knowing what they're doing, where they're going, or what they actually want out of it. Frustration, irritation, leading to all kind of things. Suicide in one case as well. क्यों? ऐसा क्यों? क्या हमें अपने बारे में सोचने के लिए कोई हादसा चाहिए? Don't take me wrong. मैं ये नहीं कह रहा कि हमारी जिंदगी में बहुत से हादसे होते हैं जो हमें ट्रैक पे वापस लाने के लिए होते हैं. Agreed. Full respect to that. लेकिन क्या हमें अपने बारे में सोचने के लिए एक हादसे का होना जरूरी है? किसी के मर जाने का होना जरूरी है? क्या मेरी लाइफ में अगर कोई फैमिली मेंबर चला जाएगा तभी मैं अपने बारे में सोचूंगा, तभी मैं अपनी जिंदगी के बारे में सोचूंगा? या मुझे पहले से सोचना चाहिए? उस वक्त तक तो देर नहीं हो जाएगी, टाइम वक्त गुजर जाएगा, सोचना चाहिए. लेकिन हम सोचते नहीं हैं. हम अपने बारे में, हम दूसरों के बारे में हमारे पास ज्यादा ख्याल होते हैं. यार वो ऐसा कर रहा है, वो ऐसा क्यों कर रहा है, वो यार उसके पीछे ये चल रहा है, उसके पीछे ये चल रहा है, उसके पीछे ये चल रहा है, ये वो ऐसा इसलिए कर रहा है. होली प्रॉफिट और प्रॉफिट मोहम्मद सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम also used to spend time alone in Ghare Hira. He would go there for days with just a handful of dates and water. And he would just not go there just like that. He would think, contemplate about his life, about the life he was living and those around him, about the thought process, the thinking. So it's okay from the religious perspective as well. And we have seen people that they spend time alone. They say that you should, it's a study that says that you should at least spend half an hour every day alone, thinking about your day or about anything else, but about yourself. But we don't. And why is it important to learn about ourselves? Why indeed? Why should we discover ourselves? Why should we spend time alone to discover ourselves? Because if we don't, negation, if we don't and we end up living this life as we are in old age, you're going to regret it. The case is in front of you. Regret, guilt, frustration, leading to sleeping pills, leading to drugs, leading to overdose, and sometimes leading to suicide as well. One such case is very fresh among all of us. Chester, Linkin Park, lead singer, fans all over the world, people singing lyrics day in, day out. In the end, it doesn't even matter. But it did matter. It did matter. He had a good life. He had kids. He had wives. He had fame, money, anything that anyone could want in this life. But he hanged himself. Misery of a loser who hasn't found himself. This is what happens when you haven't discovered yourself.